you cyberpunks and retro nerds, it's Tommy the Hammer doing another lightning quick movie review for you guys. Today I thought we would discuss the 1980s action horror film, The Wraith. And for some reason, this movie has escaped my radar for quite a while. I've been wanting to watch it. The premise alone sounds interesting as hell. Something about a killed teenager coming back as some sort of death-dealing wraith that drives a black sports car. Sounds super 80s and super rad. I can't wait to watch it. It's got a young Charlie Sheen in it. And while I peep the movie, you guys are going to be checking out the trailer. And then once we get back from that, we're going to be discussing The Wraith. Don't go nowhere, motherfuckers!
An evil force took his life. An unearthly power has brought him back. He is a phantom. A wraith. A cosmic spirit given another chance.
Are you new in town?
Yeah.
Who's the kid?
I turned my back and the next second he was there. Like magic almost.
You ever seen one of those before?
Let's just add it to our collection.
There's a kid out there using his car to kill people. Not that it's such a big deal, since it seems to be your gang he's got it in for.
Hold on! Grab the shotgun, Mama Luca.
A wraith, man! A ghost! An evil spirit, and it ain't cool!
What are you doing? Packard, stop
him! Get in the car!
What are you doing, man?
Get out of my face, Burger Boy. You wind up dead like your brother.
No! Hey, who is that guy?
I don't know. But whoever he was, he's weird and ticked off.
I see his eyes, Loomis!
Who are you?
If you've done nothing wrong, you've got nothing to fear.
I gotta say, guys, I enjoyed The Wraith quite a bit. I grew up in the 1980s, and that era will always have a special place in my heart. The cinema, the music, the style, just the basic mentality of everybody from that era really speaks to me personally, and movies like The Wraith are the perfect embodiment of that era. I think the aspect about this movie that I like the most is its consistent use of music. The soundtrack is just thumping. It's that perfect mix of electro meets the hard rock of the 1980s, and it really helps sell the mood to this overall movie. I'm no fan of Charlie Sheen, especially in recent years, but with the whole Tiger Blood era of his career. But I thought he worked in this movie, and as I watched him in the role, you know, I wasn't annoyed by him one bit, and I found his character to be kind of tragic in his own way. I found the other actors in the movie to be quite adequate, and Randy Quaid as the kind of, you know, small-town sheriff really worked in his role as well, too. He's the type of actor that can take such a cheesy movie such as The Wraith and help raise it above any cornball faults that it might have. So I find like that to be another strong suit of this movie. The music, the actors, the setting, and the fucking cars. The car chases in this movie are fucking fantastic. They must have destroyed so many cars just for the race scenes alone. And the movie overall is kind of like if you took one of those 1950s street race movies and stuck it right in the middle of the 1980s, then you would have The Wraith. But overall, guys, I would have to say this is a great movie. If you love cheeseball, you know, 1980s films where the music is just bumping, the styles are ridiculous, and the acting is hammy, then I can highly recommend this movie to you guys. Out of 10 stars, I think I'm going to give this one a 6.5. It's not a great movie by any stretch of the word, but it is fun, and if you love 80s films, then you owe it to yourself to give The Wraith a peek.